Everything starts with the seed, the genetics. We start out by doing lots of field testing to determine nutrients and pH, and then we make sure that we do as best we can early on to correct that so that the plant going into the ground is going to have the best chance possible. All the details of farming are making sure that all of these plants are getting the best chance they have to fulfill what their genetic potential is. That has to do with designing the layout of the field, the spacing, the irrigation system, and then the implementation throughout the year of all these things. We have to make sure that our watering is on time, that it's the duration of the watering is proper. That changes throughout the season. We also are very tuned into making sure that the nutrients that the plant's getting are the proper nutrients in the proper amounts throughout the season for what the plant needs and through its different stages of growth. So here we're standing in a good representation of what the genetics can do if they're in a really good soil pocket and they have really good nutrients and they've been taken good care of. And you can see, these plants are 6-7 feet tall. Right now we're seeing the development of the flower getting really close to being, in the finished state. At this point in the game, we're no more nutrients. We're allowing the plant to basically kind of clean itself out. We're just using clean water and we're trying to finish the plant and flush it out so that the product at the end in the oil is going to be the very best possible. If you look at the overall field, if you pan out and look at the whole field, you can see the consistency of the height, of the general color of the plants. We clean out most of the weeds. If you look down the rows here, everything is very clean, so that we just don't have competition from the weeds in this plant. It also allows us, when we harvest, to make sure that the material going into harvest is 100% cannabis that we intend to go in. We don't want to be picking up weeds or have any foreign matter in our sample. So that's a big part of a lot of the work we've done here, is maintaining a very clean field. At this time of year, the plant, it's an annual plant. You're seeing a lot of color change and you're seeing a little bit of stress, and that's that plant kind of shutting down and focusing everything on its flowers. Here, where we are getting ready for harvest, we are watching really closely the moisture content of the soil. We're drying things down and we're getting ready to do a sun cure, which is we cut these plants down in the field, we lay them down, and we allow the sun and our low humidity we have here in Central Oregon to cure them really well. We'll come back through and we'll tip plants back over. That way there's not a lot of damage from the sun, and we get a very consistent cure. And then we'll come through with mechanized equipment, and we will pull the plants through and strip all of the leaves and flower matter away from the stems so that we have a product that is essentially, all usable and very consistent. Here we are at the end of the season, and we're looking at the fruit of our labors. We've had a really good season. We've had very good weather and a very good crew that's taking good care of this field. We started propagating plants in mid-May and planted them into the field early mid-June. And we're right now, essentially these plants are 4 months old and they've reached, nice height, good maturity in the flower. And we really think this is going to be a superior product. We'll be able to pull oil out of this that is going to be as good as anything on the market.